One more second.
Breathing is good.
Huh?
Breathing is good.
Yeah,
breathe.
Tequila is better.
Tequila is amazing. Yeah. Yeah, we like that.
I don't know how much we had.
We like that.
Not from the tequila.
Something else, probably.
It was an egg.
You just said that. She likes to eat the shell. Yeah, the shell got. That's my secret. Eat one full egg.
There you go.
For every trial. Okay. I want to make sure I'm correct here because you know it's been a while. Okay, perfect. I came to the score I wanted, which I felt in my heart. Here's the thing I want to pass along to you guys on judging. And as a competitor, it's how I always felt it should be, which back then, you know, it's evolved. It's gotten better. When you watch a performance with a dog, and we're taught through the FCI, when we go to the FCI judges meeting, our first thing that we have to do is not think points, we have to think category of what we're watching. Is this a satisfactory performance? Is it a very good performance? Is it an excellent performance? Is it an insufficient performance? We have to look at that first and make sure that what we're taking away from points puts that dog, team, handler, and dog into that category, okay, correctly. Otherwise, you can go all day gouging the points on a dog that puts them into a category that's not the picture of what you're watching. You know what I mean? So, you know, that's why I took some time with Claire and Dolly here, because I knew what I was watching, but if I go too deep with my points, I can very quickly take them out of that category. Okay, so that's why I really wanted to really look at things and make sure that that's all okay. So, today we have Nala and Claire for their OB1 title. Again, I'm going to give you your points, but I'm also going to tell you things in a club trial that I'm never going to take off from. As well, too, BH to 1, big jump on how you get judged. 1 to 2 should be a little tougher. 2 to 3 gets a little bit tougher, you know what I mean? FH1, FH2, you know, everything as you go up should be judged just a little bit more nitpicky on stuff. So today they're going for their OB1. Do you mind me asking how old she is?
3.
She's 3. Okay. In your free healing, you have to watch a little bit. You get what we call a dead hand here. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't move, it just stays there. Okay, so you want to make sure that that's moving freely. A lot of people, not even judges, but other people will say, hey, Taylor, you know what I mean? So just make sure you're free and natural with your hand, and that may lighten her up a little bit too. She needs to have a lot more attention to the handler and healing, and a lot more positive drive for her work, you know, her work ethic, as we call it. It's there, and she's there with you. It's just her attention's up here, or not always where it should be on yourself. That's when you lose it in the corners. You know, she legs in the corners and then you go in the corner and then she's over there and then she catches up, you know, so it's legging in the corners. She needs to stay with you in the healing and be more attentive to the healing. She's slow to sit in all of her finishes and all of her basic positions. You know, she's got that hydraulic kind of like, I'm just gonna take my time a little bit. So that needs to be faster in the basic position for sit. The one thing, again, you've chosen to do, you do your about turns the same, both you guys, okay? One thing you have to be mindful of in that about turn is that you have to stay on the same plane. In other words, the same line. If you're going like this and your dog's here and you're gonna do the about turn, you've got to stay in this same position. You can't go like this and go off the field. That's incorrect. lot of points for that. And again, she needs to have more attention and keeping up with you in that phase of the healing. This puts you in the satisfactory phase for healing today. Sit out of motion. Again, the buildup should show more attention in the healing. She's slightly slow, again, to sit. All her sits are a little slow. And you pause a little bit and give a little handler help, okay? So have to be a little bit mindful of that. To make sure, puts you in the good category for that exercise today. Down with recall. Again, the buildup, she needs to show more attention. You slow down a little bit before you give a command. That's a little handler help.
It's in the skylights.
She goes down. She can go down a lot faster. For the recall, she needs to come much more quickly and more directly to you. She's not straight in the front, and when she does finish, she's not straight in the finish, and the finish is slow. So it needs to show a lot more drive for the work and a lot more quickness. It puts in the satisfactory with now with recall today. Retrieve on flat. Okay, one thing you have to be mindful of. One thing your dog's name is not is a command. So every time that you go Nala, Foos, Nala, Bring, Nala, that's a double command. And every time, I didn't take it off today, but every time you say Nala, Bring, Nala, Foos, Nala, you know, that's a double command. So just remember your dog's name is not a command. Okay? So retrieve on flat, could be gone out and picked up back to you much, much, much faster and more direct, more drive for the work, okay? She drops it in front of you, and the finish is again Nala, Bruce. So be mindful of all of those things. That puts you in the satisfactory position today for that exercise. Retrieve over the hurdle. Again, you've got double commands. You throw the dumbbell. She shows no over the hurdle and no back for the hurdle and can be much faster forward and back to you. That's a insufficient today on retrieve over the hurdle. Retrieve over the wall. Again, you show no over, no back, a drop in front of you, and two commands to finish. Again, that's an insufficient in that exercise today. Send out with down. Dog should go out much more fastly, much more straight and direct to the obedience command. Doesn't go straight, takes off to the side. That's when I told you to down her. And she does down, but takes two commands to finish. Okay. When you go to pick her up. Here we go. Yep, faster direct. Up, command times two. Yep, got that. Long down under distraction. She downs on her own when you take her over there. She's just kind of like, she needs more drive for the work. You know what I mean? Maybe you just haven't hit that button with her yet as far as where she wants to feel like she wants to do the work, so to say. So she shows no sit. She downs on her own. You've got some sniffing behavior and some, you know, non-focused behavior, but she stays down throughout the rest. So today we have 70. Somehow we got to make it a good game with her.
Yeah, she's pretty flat today.
Yep. Okay, then we have Tika and Carrie. I just want to make sure I pronounce the dogs' names right. You know, nobody could ever get Visa's name right. Tika. Okay, free healing today. Looked really nice, good position, good drive with the dog. Could be slightly more attentive every once in a while, looks off to the side, but for the most part, with you in good position. Clearly she knows what healing is. Today I put you in the good category for this exercise. Sit out of motion. The buildup is correct and is shown correctly. A little tiny bit of handler help. don't think I don't see that. With the sit command, she should react slightly faster to the command in the sit. Again, that puts you in the good category for the sit out of motion. Down with recall. Here we show a good build up again, which is correct. Little bit of handler help again on the down command, but she does react faster to the down command, which was good. The recall was shown correctly, fast and sure and straight to you, and the finish was shown correctly as well too. That puts you in the very good category for that today. Stand while running with recall. The buildup is correct, show good running healing, but when you give the command, she takes 5 steps. So she should lock up and just react more quickly to the command.
Quicklier.
That puts you in the good category for that today. Retrieve on flat. Note to you for all of your retrieves. Judges write a whole lot more than I do. You know what I mean? So you got to make sure that they're ready to watch you do what you look to them before you throw the dumbbell. You know what I mean? So to make sure that they're ready. You know, if you've got nice retrieves, you want to show them off and not have him go, I don't know, I don't see that. You know what I mean? So just a note to yourself. Retrieve on flat. Dog stays calmly in position. Throw the dumbbell. Can go slightly faster out to the dumbbell. Comes back quickly to you, straight in front. Good hold on the dumbbell, outs correctly, and finishes in the correct basic position. Puts you in a very good category for that today. Retrieve over the hurdle, again, look to the judge. I know you're in a mindset there, you just wanna go, okay, flat, no, you know what I mean? So just take your time. Retrieve over hurdle. Goes out quickly, can grab the dumbbell and come back more quickly over the jump to you. In other words, it's the grab and the turn that could be shown slightly faster. Dog comes straight in, however, bumps you with the dumbbell. That's something you gotta work on as well too, to bump you with the dumbbell. Bumps you with the dumbbell, so that puts you in the very good category today for that. Retrieve over wall. Again, everything here, she likes the wall. Fast, fast. Grabs and comes back, you know, a little bit more than the jump. I don't know if you might want to work on throwing it farther for her, you know what I mean? So it's more of a prey thing or whatever. But the wall was showing very good, correctly, fast out, fast back to you. But again, she does bump you there, so that costs you that point, puts you in a very good category today. Send out with down, the buildup is showing correctly. Dog goes out fast and sure and correctly, be mindful. This is something from the FCI. Be mindful when you do your command. And they even state it, which we'll go over in the handler seminar tomorrow, how far down that you go.
Okay.
You cannot go down to the dog's level. You have to stay up here. I didn't take points off for this, by the way. Just a note, you have to stay up here and go this. You cannot go down here with the dog, okay? But anyway, dog goes out fast, sure, correctly, knows what the exercise is, straight, and reacts immediately to the command down. The pickup and basic position is correct. That puts you in the excellent category for that today. Run down under distraction. Dog waits for the command down, stays in the down position. There is some slight sniffing on and off, but puts you in the very good category today. Today is 90 points.
Yay! Thank you.